How many times have you admired a starry rain on a clear summer night? How about a shower of comets? Right now, while you're sitting in front of the screen, dozens of comets are flying towards Earth. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. After all, the solar system has 6,600 comets, and the slightest external influence can seriously change their trajectory. On June 30th, 1908, our civilization could have perished. On this day, a huge cosmic body entered the Earth's atmosphere, collapsed due to high pressure and temperature, and exploded at an altitude of between 30 to 40 kilometers, or 18 to 25 miles. The estimated explosive power was 15 megatons, about 1,000 times more destructive than the little boy atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima in 1945. According to other sources, the power reached 50 megatons, which is equal to the effect of the largest thermonuclear tsar bomba. The incident in 1908 is known as the Tunguska event. According to the most common version, the answer to the Tunguska event is very simple. Our planet collided with a part of a comet, a fragment of which provoked a grand explosion. The collision had terrible consequences. Within a radius of 40 kilometers, or about 25 miles, trees were demolished by a shockwave and wild animals were destroyed. In the area surrounding the Taiga explosion, severe forest fires began. Every existing scientific center around the world recorded the blast. Where did this comet, almost causing a global catastrophe, come from? According to scientists, there are about 6,600 comets in our solar system. They're usually located at least between 2 to 5,000 astronomical units from the sun. Here passes the inner border of the belt of icy celestial bodies, known as the Oort cloud. Astronomers suggest that this cloud consists of two parts, an external part in the form of a sphere and an internal one in the form of a disk. The Oort cloud looks like a large swarm of bees surrounding the solar system and extending into space for 10,000 or even possibly 100,000 astronomical units. According to a widely accepted hypothesis, the objects of the Oort cloud initially formed much closer to the sun in the same process in which planets and asteroids form. Over time, gravitational interactions with young giant planets such as Jupiter drove objects into extremely elongated elliptical or parabolic orbits. The number of large comets with a core diameter of more than 1.3 kilometers or 0.8 miles in the outer Oort cloud can reach several trillions, but there could be 10 times more in the inner cloud. Because according to some models, the inner cloud is also the source for new comets entering and replenishing the relatively scarce space of the outer sphere. Just imagine hundreds of billions of huge boulders revolving around the sun that at any moment could become a comet, flying at great speeds towards Earth. Isn't this a serious threat? Well, even if the Oort cloud does look exactly like this, only a few of its inhabitants carry even a minimal threat to humanity. Yet, what makes objects so remote from the sun move closer? And is it possible to predict whether a new terrible collision threatens our planet? In the middle 20th century, Jan Hendrik Oort suggested that neighboring stars, by their gravity, force objects to gravitate from the cloud into the interior of the solar system, becoming comets visible to humans. Some astronomers have even hypothesized that very close to the sun may be a special dark star, directing thousands of dangerous objects in the direction of the Earth. Scientists suggested calling the star Nemesis, in honor of the ancient Greek goddess of retribution. According to astronomers, the influence of Nemesis has led to the largest disasters in the history of our planet, such as the Cretaceous-Paleogene extinction event, during which the last dinosaurs allegedly disappeared. The mysterious Nemesis has never been discovered, but scientists began looking for patterns between the behavior of comets and the movement of such well-known neighbors of the sun as Alpha Centauri, Sirius, or Procyon? Can it be that these very bright stars of the night sky could threaten the Earth with a shower of comets? The answer to this question was found only recently. In 2019, astrophysicists from the Poznan Observatory compared the orbits of several hundred long-period comets known to us today with the trajectories of stars nearby the Sun. Scientists concluded at least two stars influenced the movement of the comets, but it's still impossible to evaluate the influence of other stars on the Oort cloud. Most surprisingly, the stars that supposedly cause the disturbance of comets are by no means our closest neighbors. One of these stars, HD 7977, is approximately 247 light years from us. But even this distance didn't prevent it from pushing a comet deeper into the solar system. The gravitational effect of this star on the orbit of comet C/2002A3 worked such that in 2002 it passed very closely to Jupiter. At the same time, the orbit of C/2002A3 turned into a parabola, and it became a comet observable from the Earth. It turns out that even such distant stars may send huge blocks of ice in our direction. Is it not them who are to blame for the Tunguska event and other dangerous collisions? Polish researcher Rita Wisoczanska questions the current explanation for the causes of comets. Her research has shown that the gravity of neighboring stars is not enough for the emergence of all known comets. Some other force acts on the Oort cloud, which causes such intense movement inside our planetary system. One of these previously unknown forces may be the galactic tide. As you know, the solar system is located in one of the spiral arms of the Milky Way galaxy. All of the sleeves of the galaxy revolve around its center. In particular, the orbital velocity of the Sun around the center of the galaxy is approximately 220 to 240 kilometers, or 140 to 150 miles per second. With tremendous speed, we're moving with the Sun through a rather large interstellar cloud. The changing location of the solar system relative to the center of the galaxy causes the so-called galactic tide. Tidal forces stretch the Oort cloud toward the center of the galaxy and compress it along two other axes, similar to how the shape of the Earth changes due to the attraction of the Moon. In this case, the Oort cloud, in which comets are stored, is far enough away from the Sun that even the slightest external influence can seriously change the trajectory of its objects. Scientists fear that in the near future, the risk of collision of cosmic bodies with the Earth will only increase. If today the closest star to us is Proxima Centauri at a distance of about 4.2 light years, then after 1.3 million years, the star Gliese 710 will reach close to our system in only 0.11 to 1.3 light years. In this case, the gravitational impact of the new neighbor could be so great that a whole rain of comets could come falling down on the planets of the solar system. Astronomers from the Complutense University of Madrid published a report in 2018 which states that the minimum distance between Gliese 710 and the Sun is a mere 650 billion kilometers, or 400 billion miles. In this case, a star flying near us could take comets with it and move them closer to the Sun, which puts our planet in great danger. On the other hand, the convergence of other stars with the Sun is not uncommon. For example, just 70,000 years ago, nearby our system flashed two stars at once, or rather, the binary star, Schultz's star. At the same time, no tragedy occurred. The Schultz star quickly retreated, and the trajectory of the comets didn't change practically at all. So panic over a possible collision with a comet is not necessary. What's more is that the size of the Earth is negligible compared to the length of its orbit. This means that the probability of a comet and our planet meeting is extremely small. What do you think? should we be wary of the icy wanderers of the solar system? Want to surprise your friends with unusual facts about Earth and space? Then subscribe to our channel and share this video with your friends.